The techniques and behavior patterns of intruders are constantly shifting in order to exploit newly discovered weaknesses and to evade detection and countermeasures. However, intruders typically use steps from a common attack methodology. Here are the common attack steps. The first step is target acquisition and information gathering. That is, the attacker identifies the target systems using publicly available information, both technical and non-technical, and use network tools to analyze target resources. For example, the attackers can find out what network services are accessible from the internet, and the attacker may find out some email accounts of high-level company executives. The second step is initial access. This is accomplished by exploiting a remote network vulnerability. For example, a network service has a buffer overflow vulnerability that allows a remote attack to take over the service and gain access to the system. Or this can be accomplished by social engineering, whereby, for example, an attacker can send an email to a company executive with an attachment so that when the attachment is clicked, a malware is installed on that system. The third step is privilege escalation. This is taken after the initial access, and the attacker would try to use local exploit to escalate the privilege from, for example, the normal user to root privilege on the target system. The fourth step is information gathering or system exploit. That is, after an attacker has gained sufficient privilege on a system, he can then find out more about the network and the organization, and even move to another target system to further the exploit on the network. The fifth step is maintaining access. This is important because an attack may not be a one-time action. That is, the attacker may choose to come back from time to time or continue the exploit for a while. Therefore, the attacker may install backdoors or other malicious software on a target system so that he can continue to access this target system. Lastly, the attacker wants to cover his tracks. For example, the attacker can disable or even edit the system audit logs to remove evidence of attack activities. Or the attacker may install rootkits to hide the installed malware.